What's going on, everybody? My name is Tim Mui, and I share tips and tools to help you become the best digital artist in all of existence known to mankind. And in this video, I'm going to show you an easy way to create a perspective grid using the polygon tool in Photoshop. Now, one thing you have to know before we start is that this is specifically for 2021 Photoshop. So if you have an earlier version, let's say 2020 and before, I have a link down below from another video created by BAM Animation. And this is actually where I got this technique from. So the video in the description is for those of you who are on an earlier version of Photoshop. So let's go ahead and start with a blank canvas. So the first thing you should do is establish a horizon line. And the way you can do that is to press Command R to activate the rulers on your screen. And your rulers are going to be up above and on the side. And we can actually click and drag from those rulers and a line will come down and we can place this line anywhere on the canvas. And I'm gonna place it in the center. And that is gonna be our horizon line. Now, the next thing we should do is go to the shape tool. By default, it should be the rectangle tool. Now, if you click and hold on the shape tool, you're gonna find a drop down menu. And what you wanna select is the polygon tool. And you can also press Shift U to cycle through those menus. So the polygon tool is gonna be indicated by the hexagon icon. Once we got the polygon tool selected, I wanna bring your attention up to the top menu of Photoshop. And then there are certain things that we should change before we start making our perspective grid. The first thing you should do is make sure that this is selected to shape. Let's go to fill and make sure that it is selected on no fill. For stroke, let's go ahead and choose a bright color red so that we can help this grid stand out from the rest of our illustration. Make sure that our stroke is set to 1 pixel. Going all the way to the right, we're gonna go and stop at this gear right here. This is your path options. And what we wanna choose is symmetric. Make sure our star ratio is all the way down to 1%. And then check the box from center. So before we move on to the last part, make sure that your entire path option looks like this. Now let's go ahead and go to the hexagon on the side until we see this hand icon. And we're gonna drag to the right until it reaches the number 100. And this will show how many points of the star we can have. So once we have all of these settings, I'm gonna click from the center. And now we can see that we have created a 1-point perspective grid. And we can draw a box in here, 1-point perspective, a wheel, something, whatever you want to draw. Now, most of our illustrations are going to be 2-point perspective. So we're gonna choose the direct selection tool, and that shortcut is going to be the letter A. And with the direct selection tool, we're gonna want to select this center vanishing point. And to do that, I'm going to click on one of these white areas between the red lines, and I'm going to drag to create this box until it completely surrounds the center vanishing point. Now, once I have the center vanishing point selected, I'm gonna hold down Shift and I'm gonna click and drag to the left. Holding down Shift will make it so that the vanishing point doesn't stray from the horizon line. And once we click off the canvas, we can see that one of our vanishing points is established. So let's go ahead and create our second vanishing point. With the polygon 1 layer selected, let's go ahead and copy this layer by pressing Command J. Now go back down to your original vanishing point and lock it so that we don't accidentally move it. Now let's go to our new vanishing point. And we're gonna do the same thing with the direct selection tool. We're gonna go ahead and select that vanishing point that we created. And we're going to click Shift and drag our center vanishing point in the opposite direction. And then here we go. We have our perspective grid. Now, all of these lines can look a little bit confusing. And one thing that I like to do is I like to change the color of our second vanishing point. So I'm gonna go all the way to stroke and I'm gonna change it to kind of like a dark blue. That will help our right vanishing point look a little bit different than our left one. And then from this, now we can create anything on our perspective grid. We can put this in a folder by highlighting both layers and pressing Command G. And then we can lower the opacity just so that we can lessen how confusing it looks. And then we can make our illustration from here. Even if you're not creating heavily structured environments with cars and buildings, having a perspective grid there, an established horizon line and vanishing points will really help your environment and your illustration stand out. Now, you don't have to draw everything perfectly on the grid lines, but having it there just as a general guide is such a game changer, especially when it came to my illustrations. Whenever I start an illustration, I always establish a horizon line and two vanishing points just to help me out. If you learned something new, go ahead and click that like button down below and click that subscribe button and that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. That's all I have for you today. Bye. Gosh, I hope that'll make sense. Please don't make me record this again.